Hello. Welcome to RTC TV4. My name is Gian Rensler, here with your boy, Dakota Hayden.
Hey, what's up, folks?
Welcome to another night of beautiful high school football here at the Caston Crater. This matchup is between the Caston Comets and the North Judson.
North Judson Blue Jays. Comets looking to get another secure win tonight. They went 6-0 against Triton last week.
Yeah. North Judson Blue Jays will start out with the ball here on the 41-yard line. Hand off play.
Rush stop by number 21, Ephraim Mosqueda. My bad, that was Casey Ault. I misread the numbers. Need to check my glasses. I'm going blind here.
In off play once again by the Blue Jays. Third down with 3 yards to go. Ball on the 47-yard line.
Number 40, Casey Ault. And number 44, Zach Slocum, putting a stop to the advance made by North Judson. Comets looking to keep him back.
Another full house here at the Crater.
Yep. Lovely crowd out, and for North Judson, too. It's nice to see so many people coming out to appreciate the sport.
Handoff. And he stopped, and that will force fourth down for the Blue Jays. Let's see what they do here. It's going to be pretty interesting to see what they do here. It looks like they're going for it.
Let's see just how far they can make it.
No, I think they're setting up as a punt.
Yeah.
Here's the Blue Jays as they're set for the punt.
Kick.
And they're going to let that go. Ooh. And that rolls into the end zone. Ball will be on the 20-yard line, and first and 10 for the Comets. Here we go. We got the junior quarterback, Brady Hartman. We got Tate Cowell as the right receiver. We got Casey Ault as the running back. Casey Ault was really the force last game.
Oh, yeah, 6-0 against Triton.
And here he is, as you see, run the ball again. You're going to see a lot of that, I think, for tonight for Casey Ault.
I would think. Considering last week it was all Casey. He was player of the game last week. He destroyed Triton's defense and pushed through.
Picked up 4 yards on that handoff. And here we go. Comets on the 24-yard line. Handoff play to Casey Ault again, and he has stopped at the 23-yard line. Third down for the Comets.
North Judson's defense seems to be stacking up against our running game tonight.
And we got third down here with 4 yards to go. Ball on the 26-yard line for the Comets. Let's see if they'll change stuff up here and go for a pass.
I don't think so. It's not in their playbook.
Oh, Brady Hartman looking. Oh, incomplete.
Incomplete to number 35, Colton Welker. Couldn't make that complete pass.
And that will force fourth down with 4 yards to go, a ball on the 26-yard line for the Comets. Comets are setting up as the punt. Getting ready here to punt the ball off for the Comets. Lewis will be punting the ball off for the Comets. Good punt right there.
Good punt by Phoenix.
And he's down at the 44-yard line.
Stop by number 77, Chris Smith. North Judd retains the ball at the 45-yard line.
Comets did a great job last position on stopping them on defense.
Oh, yeah. Solid wall line of defense played by the Comets.
And off play. And he is down. Loss of gain right there. Tate Cow was right there on the stop for the Comets. That's going to be a loss of yards right there for the Blue Jays.
Tate Cow fast as lightning.
Second down with 13 yards to go. Ball on the 42-yard line for the Blue Jays. It looks to see if there's a fumble out there going on.
I saw a scramble, didn't see what happened.
Tate Cow was right there again, as we see.
Tate Cow right where he needs to be.
Number seven. Number seven is Tate Cow.
Right when it counts.
Now we got third down for the Blue Jays. 12 yards to go. Ball on the 43-yard line. Pass play here for the Blue Jays. Finds, almost interception by
number 20, Brady. And fourth down for Blue Jays, 12 yards to go. Seems unlikely, but we've seen stuff like this happen before.
Number 7, Lewis to punt for the Blue Jays.
And the punt is off. And they're going to let that go once again. And the Blue Jays will touch the ball at the 9-yard line.
Comets retain ball, first and 10.
Once again, another great defense position for the Comets there.
Oh, yeah. So far, they played a pretty well defense.
Here we go, ball on the 7-yard line for the Comets. Looked like a quarterback sneak right there.
That's what they attempted to do, it was stopped.
And it looks like there was a fumble on the play.
Yeah, and the Blue Jays recovered that.
Yes.
So they'll be getting it right back there on the 8-yard line.
Must have lost the ball as soon as he tried to sneak in. And I couldn't really see it from here, but
no. Slippery fingers.
Blue Jays get the ball, and they're on the 9-yard line. Head off play by Blue Jays. Picks up 3 on the game.
Stop there.
Lewis on the
by number 20, Brady Hartman. And I do believe that was number 53, Trenton Howard.
Penalties against the Blue Jays. We'll leave the block in the back. Back it up to the 18-yard line. Still first down for the Blue Jays.
Handoff play for the Blue Jays.
And there he goes.
And he is down at the 25-yard line.
No gain on the play. Second down for the Blue Jays.
Comets so far been able to hold them back, but with 18 yards to go on the second down, hopefully they can keep them up.
Flag is out.
Incomplete pass. There is a flag on the play. Trying to see what's being called here on the field.
Five-yard penalty on the Jays.
Back him up 5 yards to the 22-yard line. Still second down.
That will back the Blue Jays up by 5 yards, and now be the ball on the 22-yard line. 23 yards to go for the Blue Jays. Let's see what they got in store right here. Looks like quarterback Rod hands it off. And penalty flag is on the field. I think that is coming back. What do you say here, Dakota?
I would have to agree with you on that one.
I think when he handed it off to the second person, I think that guy was ahead of him.
Yeah.
And that's going to come back for the Blue Jays. It was a pretty good move by the Blue Jays, the first handoff that they did, but once after that, they handed off to the next guy and took it a little too far on that one.
Just a little bit. And it looks like they're not going to get any yard gainage off of it.
And yes, it was a legal forward pass by the Blue Jays. It'll be third down for the Blue Jays, 18 yards to go, ball on the 18-yard line. Pass play here, deep
throws
in the end zone, incomplete. And that will force fourth down for the Blue Jays.
Real close to an interception there for number 35. Just barely out of his reach. Slightly cloudy tonight. I think it's even starting to try to rain, unlike last week. Yeah. It was bright and sunny and clear skies. That shouldn't stop us from having a great night tonight on football in RTC.
Ooh, looks like a dropped it. Going for the deep pass. That should be intercepted. Aww.
Oh, almost intercepted by number 7, Tate Cowell.
And that'll be turnover on downs, and the Comets will take ball. Once again, the Comets stopped him. Ball's on the 18-yard line. Ooh, looks like there's already a penalty flag out on the field. What is this, like the third, fourth penalty flag?
I'd have to say about
probably. It's just the first quarter, too.
Yeah. Five-yard advantage for the Comets.
And the Comets will march the ball up by 5 yards, and now the ball will be on the 23-yard line. Handoff play. Good chunk of yards right there by the Comets, and that would be second down.
Stop made by 58,
Gage
Sin. And it's enough for a Comet.
First down! First down by Comets. Got enough yards.
Ball will be on the 28-yard line for the Comets. Hey. Toss over.
35, Colt Welker on the carry around the right side. Gets it up to about the 31-yard line. Second down for the Comets.
And that will be second down for the Comets with 7 yards to go. Ball on the 31-yard line. Handoff play again. Gets him up to the 35-yard line.
Number 40, Casey.
Once again, Casey all on the carry.
Football's at the 34-yard line. Third down, Comets.
It's only first quarter, but so far North Judd's been able to read all of Caston's run plays just like that. Either they got to figure out a new strategy or we're going to have some trouble here.
Yeah. Let's see if they can get this 5 yards here. Pass play. Hey, Fred Mosquito, and he keeps going. Ephraim Mosquito with the amazing catch picks up the first down for the Comets.
Excellent pass play by the Comets. Very rare for them. They usually run running. They usually run. So very rare for them to do a pass, but it worked to perfection.
It is lightly sprinkling here at the crater. I didn't really see no rain in the forecast. It was supposed to just be all clear, cloudy.
Yeah, but the clouds, they seem to have caught up with us. Hopefully, actually, the game will keep going. They don't stop games until they see lightning, so we'll be all right. Two minutes to go in the first quarter. Hand off to number
eight. Gets through the hole right there.
Blake Albright.
I've been really impressed with Blake Albright coming in once in a while, getting a pretty good chunk of yards, coming in as the running back. He's done pretty good for the Comets the last game, and that was a good play right there for the Comets.
He's done impressive work so far that we've seen.
As he's getting pulled out right now, and Casey Alt's going back in for him. You know, that's what the Comets need. They need people coming in and out, giving, you know, a break, a one-play break, and make sure that they're getting enough energy and staying on top of everything.
Again, 76, Chris Tussey on the stop for the Blue Jays. Fourth down for the Comets. And a long six.
There are less than 1 minute to go for the first quarter. Comets on the 5 yard, I'm sorry, Comets 5 yards to go on the 47 yard line. Timeout called. We're going to take a quick break and we'll be right back to you. Thanks for tuning in to RTC TV.
Okay, when we first started, this was all the way to like max. And then I switched it to medium. Sorry. And then I switched it to medium. So do you remember what we did last game? Was it medium?
Yeah, it was medium.
Okay.
Yeah, we don't want max or else it's going to, especially since we're outside, it might get too like feedbacky.
Okay.
Guys, I know what I said, so I stuck my tongue out.
Let's cover this
like,
up. Let's cover up this. I might cover this up, guys.
And we're back with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first quarter. Comets either going to run out the clock here or go for one real quick play.
Fourth down for the Comets.
Be fourth down here for the Comets. 5 yards to go. Hand off. And he has stopped, and that would be turnover on downs.
40 Casey Allen on the carry. Lost 2 yards. The Blue Jays take over on downs at the 50-yard line.
Shakes him off.
Stop him. And North Judd makes a touchdown.
Touchdown for the Blue Jays. It was a great run for the Blue Jays. He shook off that first guy at him, then just took off running. Good.
In all honesty, it was a really good move by the Blue Jays.
Good one right there. Not the way the Caston Comets would want it, but happens. It happens. It's part of the game. You know.
Right, right. It's all about the game.
Zane Bradley on the hold. And it is. Score of the Blue Jays 7, the Comets 0.
Blue Jays get that added on field goal kick for one more point, makes it 7-0, heading into the second quarter.
Thank you. Cedar. Deep for the Comets.
Oh, Judd lining up for the kickoff. Ball's kicked.
Looks like a squid kick. Comets get the ball. Comets have the ball. Ball will be on the 40-yard line for the Comets. Let's see what they can do here in this 15 seconds. They'll just run it out and come back in the second quarter and go from there, or will they try to?
That's what I'd try and do, but then again, I'm not an expert on the sport, so.
Yeah, I think I would just run the ball and come back at it in the second quarter.
Yeah.
End off play for the Comets.
End off to number 35, Colton Walker. And that'll end it for the first quarter. Thank you for tuning in to RTC TV. We'll be right back. All right, and we're back. Score 0-7. North Judd with the lead. Second quarter. Comets pass play. Stop by North Judson.
To the 46-yard line, and found a first down.
But just enough yards to make it a first down.
Penalty flag is thrown on the field.
I'm going to call that a pass interference. And yep, that's what's called. Comets gain first down again.
End off play for Nair Mosquito. He's taken right down.
Almasita up the middle. Loss bounce back to the 35-yard line at 2 yards. We'll mark it at the 34.
Running plays aren't doing too well for the Comets so far, but I got confidence they could sneak a guy or two through there.
Be here, second down for the Comets. 12 yards to go. Ball on the 35-yard line for the Comets.
Brady.
Tony Brady Hartman on the quarterback keeper. It's out of bounds at the 35-yard line. Loss of a yard on
Brady got rushed out at the 35-yard line. Third down.
Thirteen yards to go here for the Comets. Fake handoff pass. Brady Hartman looking for someone.
For incomplete.
Incomplete pass.
Incomplete pass to number 44, Zach Slocum.
Bradley on the defense for the Blue Jays. Fourth down for the Comets.
He'll be here, fourth down, with 13 yards to go for the Comets.
Brady looking for a pass.
Oh!
Pass gets blocked.
And that pass is incomplete. And that will force turnover on down. Hartman looks a little shaken up right there on that hit.
At the 35-yard line.
Be here, ball on the 35-yard line for the Blue Jays. Handoff play for the Blue Jays.
Niefren, number 21, and Phoenix Singleton, number 52, seem to stop the Jays from making an advance.
Football at the 43-yard line. Second
down
for the Blue Jays.
2 yards to go for the Blue Jays. Ball on the 44-yard line. Oh.
Blue Jays.
The penalty Stop. Flag is thrown out.
Nine, Peyton Petrie on the carry. Quarterback keeper. Stopped by Slocum. And 58, John Mitchell. Penalty flag on the field.
What do you think that was on, Dakota?
I'm not sure.
I think that's going to be on the Blue Jays.
I'm not sure.
And it looks like it is. They placed the ball back 5 yards.
I was looking at the collision that happened with number 9 from the Blue Jays and number 21 from Caston Efren. Completely slid, knocked his helmet off.
Be here, second down for the Blue Jays. Hand off.
Somebody gets around.
And he is brought down. He almost ran a mile right there before he could get down, scrambling back and forth right there.
Didn't know where to go. Ran right into number 53, Trent Howard.
Trent Howard, as you see on defense, he's getting a lot of hits right in there. Big key in the Comets defense.
Blue Jays go for a pass.
Deep pass.
And incomplete.
And that will make fourth down with 10 yards to go for the Blue Jays.
Fourth down for the Blue Jays. Comets need to hold them back so they can retain the ball and end up hopefully tying them before the second quarter ends. Casey running.
Casey, oh, the 40, the 30, the 20, 10.
He keeps going.
And he keeps going, and that gets the Comets going. I was just waiting for something like that to happen here.
First and goal, thanks to number 40, Casey Auld. What an amazing run. This is just what the Comets needed to tie up the game. Timeout called on the field. We'll be right back with you right after the break.
Starting at 8 o'clock in the morning.
And we're back. Caston, first down, first and goal. Taking the play. Blake Albright had the carry, got stopped by North Judson.
18 Logan Block on the stop for the Blue Jays. Second down for the Comets. The junior high football team will travel to North Judson tomorrow for a 12:30 kickoff. The JV game for tomorrow has been canceled.
And he has stopped down on the inside the 5-yard line. That will make it third down with 3 yards to go.
Comets need to rush this in for a touchdown in order to keep up with North Judson.
And the junior high volleyball team will not be participating in the McConaughey tournament tomorrow.
And once again, thank you for watching this broadcast. You could share this on Facebook with your friends, anything. So
tune in to rtctv.com, check out our previous footage and tonight's footage whenever it gets uploaded.
Or you could even go on YouTube. All the videos are all in there. If you want to go watch a recap of it, just type in RTCTV4 in Rochester and it should be able to pop up for you. And then all the hit videos and everything should be there. So check it out. Some great stuff to watch on there.
I do enjoy our self-advertising.
It is pretty great.
Fourth down, 1 yard to go for the Comets. Fourth and goal from the 1 foot line.
Here we go, fourth down for the Comets. Let's see what they can do here.
These Comets are so close. They really need a touchdown right now.
Ball is just on the 1 yard line.
They're right there.
Right. Quarterback sneak. Brady pushes through.
Is he there?
It's touchdown. There. For the
touchdown,
Comets. Let's check out that recap. By Casey All had the big run on the return. Got all the way up to the first down and goal for the. And then. Couple stop plays, and then Brady sneaks it right in.
Common's going to go for the two-point conversion. That'll put them ahead if they can make it. Flag called by ref.
Penalty flag on the field. Delay a game against the Comets.
And that will back them up a little bit.
Back not going to be good for the two-point conversion.
And no good. No good for the Comets.
That'll keep North Judson ahead by 1 point. 1 point only. North Judson takes the lead by 1 point. There still is more points scored tonight than there was last week, though. Comets won 6-0 against Triton last week. A great fight between the two of them, but only one touchdown was scored, and that was by Comets. So at least this is already turning out to be a more higher scoring game than last week. Makes it more intense, more entertaining, more fun, if you ask me.
Roger Flint will tee it up to kick off for the Comets. 18 Logan Block is deep for the Blue Jays.
Comets second quarter with a little over 7 minutes to go. Getting prepared for another kickoff.
Comets getting ready to kick this ball off.
But Judd retains ball. And
it'll be stopped at the 45-yard line. 45-yard line.
At the 45-yard line. 43 it is.
40. 44. End off play. What a stop by Ephraim Mosquito with the hit.
Nice tackle. Slammed right into him and took him straight down.
That Mosquito being big for the Comets here on the defense. And off play once again by the Blue Jays. And up to the 45-yard line.
Stop made by Colton Walker. And 54, Wesley York in there for the Comets.
48-yard line.
Third down for the Blue Jays.
Blue Jays call a timeout. Thank you again for tuning in to RDC TV. We'll be right back with you after the break.
And we're back. Third down for the Blue Jays with a little over 6 minutes to go. Second quarter. Blue Jays up 7-6. Hand off play once again by the Blue Jays.
Taker Boyd on the carry.
I'd say he got the first down on that one. Yep. First down for the Blue Jays. Ball on the 48-yard line.
Football left at the 46-yard line. First down for the Blue Jays. York and Smith on the stop for the Comets.
Hand off play. And he is brought down by Tate Cowell.
Tyler Blount on the carry. Stop made by number 7, Tate Cowell. Football at the 40-yard line. Second down for the Blue Jays.
second down for Blue Jays, 4 yards to go. So far been running mostly handoff plays.
Comets seem to figure out something right here to stop them. And handoff play once again by the Blue Jays.
I'm gonna haul tail.
40 Casey Alt, 66 Roger Flint on the stop for the Comets.
Ball will be on the 38-yard line.
Third down for the Blue Jays.
Third down for the Blue Jays here.
Official timeout.
Be here, third down for the Blue Jays. Ball on the 38-yard line. Hand off play again. Blue Jays going up, and he's 30-yard line.
That's a
first down.
That's definitely a gain of yards. Let's say about 27-yard line.
First down for the Blue Jays.
First down, Blue Jays. Keep running those handoffs, but they seem to be working so far. They gained them a pretty decent amount of yards so far.
Handoff play again. Gets up to...
Handoff play blocked again by 21 Efren Mesquita,
the 28-yard line.
69 Peyton.
21-yard line.
22, Peyton Hendrick, being about 6'1", 310 pounds, it's going to be tough to get through him. Definitely a valuable defensive asset.
We need to have a block on the carry. Stop made by Trent Howard for the Comets. Football to 20-yard line. Third down, Blue Jays.
Be here. 3 minutes to go left till the half.
Noah Judd, another handoff play. Stopped by the Comets. Didn't quite make it to the first down.
Stop made by Powell and Howard.
Actually, I lied. They did make the first down. Blue Jays just constantly with them handoff plays.
41, the ball carrier for the Blue Jays.
No doubt they are doing their job.
Let's take it down with 10 yards to go. 10 yards to go, ball on the 15-yard line.
Ooh.
Ooh. I'm not sure if he tried to jump over that, over him or not.
It seemed like he was going for it. Couldn't give enough height on that one.
He's going to have to get in the weight room a lot more.
Oh, yeah.
And get that vertical up.
16, Mark Smith on the shot.
Ooh. Hayes brought down at the 20-yard line. We got 1 minute remaining before the half
21,
here.
21, able to stop North Judson from running for more yards.
Fourth down here for the Blue Jays with 9 yards to go. Ball on the 17-yard line.
A little under a minute till we approach halftime. Comets need to hold back North Judson just a little bit longer.
I'm not sure what they're trying to figure out here. I think maybe.
Timeout called on the field. We'll be right back with you after this little break.
Really? All right, so what do we need to do? Like, give us some stuff to talk about.
Oh yeah, I listened to that and I was like, oh. Did anybody say anything to you?
Everybody said everything. Hey, we'll revise.
What?
We'll do a different thing after halftime.
Like 192.
Yeah. Well, hey, I'm revising after halftime anyway. I was gonna say something about the band and the cheerleaders after halftime anyway, so because the band will be gone. Dark and it's slightly raining. You want me to get pumped for that?
Yeah, yeah. Okay. Let's go.
I can work. I know. I'm intrigued. I'm learning as much as I am hyped.
And we are. All right, let me do it this time.
And we are back here.
Oh, the bam, bam, bam. That's great. 30 seconds left on the clock. Blue Jays leading 7-6.
All right, let's see what the comments, see if they can stop him here. Four turnover on down here. Let's see. Here we go. And he's scrambling. He's scrambling. He's going around. He's looking for a pass. He's throwing it deep into the end zone. Ooh,
incomplete.
Man, that has to be hard on the quarterback. He scrambled around so many times, and he found that guy right in the middle, and man. I mean, he's going to have to buy his quarterback some kind of meal after the game to make up that one.
Yeah.
I mean, wow.
Good luck on the Comets part, though.
I mean, that's almost junior high football right there. What do you think? Hail Mary right here for the Comets?
They could try.
I mean, why not just go for it? I mean, what do you got to lose?
Yeah,
I mean,
20 seconds, little under 20 seconds.
Till halftime, just go for it.
Might as well.
And here we go. And they will kneel it. That's just original play.
Yeah.
We need some excitement, you know? We need a good – no, we got to get going here. Hail Mary, get something going.
Just to bring up the intensity of the game. And that's going to end it for the second quarter. Going to send us into halftime. Thank you for tuning in to RGC TV. We will be right back after the break. And welcome back. Halftime just finished up. North Judson up 7-6 on the Comets. Third quarter just about ready to start.
Comets will return the ball here as we start the third quarter.
Before we get started off of the third quarter, we just once again like to thank you all for tuning in to RTC TV. We got a great game here tonight.
KCL is back deep for the Comets. See, I'm pretty sure with this, what happened the last time, I don't think they'll try to kick it to KCL. I think they'll probably kick it off to one of the either sides here.
Probably.
And they actually kick it right to the middle. Ephraim Mosquito gets the ball. 30, the 40. And stops.
He's down at about the 35-yard line. Decent start for the Comets. Would you look at that? Got it right on the money, 35-yard line. Getting better at this. Before we get started here on the third quarter, I'd like to throw a little shout out to the Comet Band. We thank them for coming out here every Friday night for the football games, rain or shine. Beautiful music played by.
They're always out here.
Lead director, Mr. James Byrne.
Oh, and incomplete. Now bring up second down for the Comets. 10 yards to go. Ball on the 35-yard line.
It was real close to an interception there for North Judd. Don't need any of that.
I'm looking for the Comets to hand the ball off to KCL right here. I think getting the ball off to him, I think you'll be halfway decent.
Oh, easily. After the plays he showed last week against Triton, definitely a valuable asset to the offensive team.
And I'll play the KCL. KCL takes it in, and he has stopped and bringing back, and he is down at the. What would you say that where he got stopped at, Dakota?
I'd say about 34.
Yeah.
Or, you know, I could be completely wrong and on the other side for 37.
37.
Regardless, third down.
Hand off. Looking
going
for the pass. Brady Hartman shakes it off.
He gets
it thrown. Ooh, incomplete.
Incomplete to Zach Slocum,
Blue Jays,
number 44.
Safety, almost had the ball there.
Number 44, Zach Slocum. I got to say, I really enjoy his arm sleeve he's got rocking there with the red and the blue. Really supporting the Caston colors tonight.
I think the Blue Jays had the Butterfingers tonight on their hands.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, they missed that touchdown in the at the end of the second quarter. Missed it right in there. And
they've had a few chances at interceptions that they couldn't make complete either.
They just have the butter hands tonight. I mean, it's not raining that hard. I mean, it's just lightly sprinkling, but I guess it can affect a little bit, but not that much, I would not assume. And Comet's about to punt the ball off.
Phoenix Singleton with the punt. A lot short. North Judd stopped by number 66. Roger Flint.
I mean, this is Roger Flint's first year at football. He's a senior. I mean, he's doing pretty good for the Comets, I'll say. In the last game, he had a pretty decent game. And this so far, he's doing pretty darn good this game, too.
And so far, I heard have been using him as a pretty decent kicker.
Yeah, he's been pretty good on that end, too.
North Judd back with the ball on the 47-yard line.
Let's see what they'll do here as they line up in a three-man handoff play to the fullback. Number 41 up to the 50-yard line. Looks almost as he lost the ball, and Ephraim Amoscuto tried to take the ball out of it, but he's already down, so that'll be Blue Jays' ball.
It seems like number 66, Roger Flint, seemed to have gotten hurt from that last play.
A little shaken up right there as he's coming off. He's looks like he might be limping in his left ankle. Kind of looks like right there.
That's all right.
I don't know if you could have seen that. You'll have to
good effort by
wind
Roger
that
Flint,
back
though.
And see, put that in slow-mo and see what actually went down right there. Handoff play. Up
and
to
the number
55,
seven's getting through.
40.
He's open. Stop him.
And he is stopped.
Stop
at
him.
The
that will give North Judd a first down.
Blue Jays stopped by 52. Phoenix Singleton for the Cubs. First down for the Blue Jays.
Just barely got him. He had an open run right there.
The ball's at the 39-yard line.
Also, feel free to check us out on Facebook at RTCTV4. We post a whole bunch of updates on different events like volleyball, all sports that we have at Caston. They'll be all covered on there this year. So be on the lookout. Like the page. Share the page.
Now, of course, you might always not get the lively commentary you get here tonight, but it's still good footage to check out.
Yes, for sure. We'll try to do as many games as we can possible. We will most likely do all the football games, so you guys can all be on the lookout for that.
Second down, Blue Jays.
Blue Jays second down on the 37-yard line. And so far, from what I've seen, it's been a lot of handoffs from both teams, actually.
Coach Jones getting fired up down there by the sideline, getting his guys trying to get him going.
Or yelling at them because they're not doing that great of a job. But I can't say that. They're putting a pretty decent fight to the North Judson.
Handoff play again up to the 30. 28-yard line. Ethan Mosquito with another stop. But that picked up, the Blue Jays pick up the first down.
Just slowly but surely, the Blue Jays keep pushing back the Comets. We need to see a more stronger defense play.
Handoff play once again by the Blue Jays up to the
stop by Ephron again, number 21.
Was that Ephron Emesquito with another stop?
That was.
He's just all over the place tonight for the Comets.
He's fired
on the defensive
up tonight.
End.
Football's at the 25-yard line.
North Judd with 6 yards to go. Second down. There we go. We're all set up for the next play.
They've been running the ball offensively
North
a
Judd
lot.
North Judd wide open. Stop him.
For the Blue Jays.
And North Judson was wide open there to go in for the touchdown. That'll put them up 13-6. I'll be honest, that was an awesome play by North Judson.
Barnett to attempt the extra point for the Blue Jays.
Blue Jays going for a field goal for an extra point. They were successful last time. Let's see what happens this time.
Oh, fake.
Ooh,
he's going in.
Him out.
And he gets stop. In there for the two.
Hope he made
and that
it
will
in.
Put the Blue Jays up by 15. Lead the game 15-6.
This is not good for the Comets.
And it's a good hard play right there, pushing himself through.
It looks like number 44, Zach Slocum, also seems to have gotten hurt. He's limping about off to the side. Nothing bad to say about him, though.
Yeah.
He had a great game so far tonight.
Blake Albright coming in for the Comets. And also number 58, John Mitchell, comes in.
So
the Comet teammates seem to be a little bit roughed up here on the sidelines. It's not good to have that bad of a fallback.
kick off by North Judd.
Man, that was a big kick right there.
Caught by Efren.
And to the 20, gets past the 20, up to the 25.
Juked him out.
And is stopped at the 29-yard line.
Good run by Efren.
Stop made by 35, Brian Calvin.
First and 10 for Comets at the 30-yard line.
They really need a big drive right here on the offensive end. They need something. Handoff play. He is stopped at the 32-yard line.
30, Casey Alba on the carry.
Comets played a few rare pass plays early on in the game, and I'm thinking they're going to need to start pulling that out here right about now. They seem to be stopping all the handoff plays that they've been usually running.
Seven minutes and 15 seconds to go here in the third quarter.
Hand off to Efren.
And he has stopped.
So it's about the 36-yard line.
Zach Conrad comes into the game, number 12, for Tate Cal as the tight end. And I'll play once again the Emesquito, and he has stopped right. Picks up 2 yards right there.
We're gaining yards, but not enough. It's going. But it was just enough to make a first down for Comets. Slowly but surely, they're making pace.
What was that, a quarterback sneak?
An attempt.
I honestly don't know why the Comets pull off the quarterback sneak for. I mean, they only pick up, one or 2 yards?
It worked effectively when they were first and goal, second.
Well, I mean, that's a different situation. You see the balls on the 1 yard line last
true
time.
True point, but.
I mean,
I do agree with you. It doesn't seem right to have it all the way out here. Unless they thought they could pull through. But
I just don't see why you would do a quarterback sneak. On, you know, what, balls on what, 35-yard line?
Yeah.
Calls a quarterback sneak. I just think it's a little odd, I mean. But.
Oh, Brady.
And here we go. We got a pass, by now, and it's
incomplete. Pass meant for number 35.
It looks like a penalty flag. Colton, that's going to be on the Blue Jays. And that's going to be a bring up a first down for the Comets.
Penalty pass interference against the Blue Jays.
Ball's on the 47-yard line for the Comets. Let's see what they can do here. Like I said, the Comets will have it here, first and 10. Ball on the 43. What do you say what they'll do here, Dakota?
I want to see them go for a pass. I know it's rare for the Comets to go for a pass play, but like these running, they're getting some yards occasionally, but it's not consistent as it was last week.
Yeah, I think the most effective thing for the Comets this year is just going to be running the game, honestly. They lost a good quarterback last year, Trey Young. He was really good for the Comets on passing game.
But to give credit where it's due, Brady Hartman's done a wonderful job in his place.
Though. Yeah, I mean, like I said, this is his first year as a quarterback, so starting quarterback on varsity level. So, I mean, I think he's doing pretty decent. There's some things, you know, you could always work on there and here.
Of course.
But, I mean, you got to give some credit to him. I mean, they're doing good. Looks like a false start by the Comets there.
Was the ref demon as?
It is starting to rain a little harder here. Sprinkles getting a little harder.
Yeah, you can see the lovely crowd that's come out to the crater to view their Comets starting to pull out some umbrellas.
Don't want to get their hair wet.
Of course not.
Handoff play again. KCO and it gets a good chunk of yards. Up to the 30-yard line for
that's gonna
a
be
first down.
First down for the Comets.
Like I said, I mean, you're going to see a lot of the running game from the Comets. You're not really going to see that much passing. It's just not their strong point.
It's rare, but sometimes it works. And it looks like number 44, Zach's right back in the game.
After that play, he was shooken up. Looks like he's back at it. He's gone right back in.
Glad to see it wasn't too bad of an injury.
Yeah. I cannot tell if Roger Flint is in or not, but I think he's...
Nope, he's out onside.
Yep, he's still a little shaken up after that hard hit he got.
That's all right, though. That's all right.
We're going to have to get in the ice bath, soaking that, and, you know, those muscles up, come back.
Hold on the carry. Second down, Comets.
Be here. Second down for the Comets. Ball on the 29-yard line.
9 yards to go. Second down, Comets. So a little over 4 minutes left to go for the third quarter. Brady looking
pass
for a
play.
Pass.
Brady's looking for something. Looks like he's just going to take off
running. Oh, he's going to go.
And goes right out of bounds. I honestly do not know what was called there on the offense end. Almost don't really know. And I think Coach Slocum, I think he calls most of the plays on defensive end. I know in the Ferris Tribune sports paper, the article, Coach Jones giving credit at the last game for Coach Slocum for most of the plays that he's called on the defensive end. So
he's been very effective in the strategy on that. I will give him credit.
Yeah. Once again, another handoff play to Efren, and he's stopped down. Maybe for a loss of yards right there. I don't know. We'll have to see.
Fourth down for the Comets.
Comets at fourth down. They may need to make a big play here.
We got 8 yards to go. Ball is on the 28-yard line for the Comets. Tate Cowell's coming back in the game. He'll be at the right receiver spot. Shock, we got 6-5 on the clock.
Scramble.
And once again, you see that quarterback sneak.
Went for a fumble, who recovered? Blue Jays recovered the ball.
It looks like number 44, Slocum, is limping off the field as say he's going to have her ankle there. Number 8, Blake Albright comes into the game.
The Comets retake the defense as North Judd goes on the offensive.
It looks like the Comets only have 9 guys out there on defense, and I honestly do not know what's going on. They can't figure something out here.
No idea, but a timeout was called. Thank you again for tuning in to RTC TV. We'll be right back after the break.
And thank you for sponsoring us pizza rolls or something like that. Like the live events and stuff like that.
We're not dead.
Get it.
If food injured your hair, I'm like...
We weren't dead third quarter, though. Yeah, I told you we can bounce back. What do you mean by that? What? I can't say anything funny without insulting our own players, because I know our players. Why?
Here we go.
And welcome back. No, Judson. I think they went for a handoff. Stopped abruptly by the Comets. Comets.
Let's see how many guys Caston have out there on defense. They got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. They got 12 guys out there that I can count. They did have 9 on that one position and had to call that timeout because something they couldn't figure out, the right guys, they didn't know who should be out there or not.
Well, if the guys keep getting injured, we're going to start running out of guys to throw out there. Comet's still down 6-15.
Second down for the Blue Jays. Looks like a false start by the Comets.
Penalty flag on the field, encroachment against the Comet defense.
That'll be a false start. A false start by Mark Smith, number 60.
Second down for Blue Jay. Football at the 31-yard line.
Here we go, shooting off again, a little bit over 2 minutes.
Penalty flag again on the field.
Penalty called. That looks like it's going to be another false start again.
Penalty is encroachment against the defense. 5-yard walk off again. Still second down for the Blue Jays.
It's not helping.
Ball on the 36-yard line for the Blue Jays. Handoff play, and he gets up to the 40-yard line.
He's
45 to 50, and stopped us at the 52-yard line.
Colton Welker stopped him, number 35. Just barely, though. He was number 7 for North Judd, was wide open. Comet defense struggling a little bit here.
We're going to have to figure something out here as Blue Jays hand off the ball again. He stopped right there shortly and quickly.
It's back and forth.
53 Trent Howard gets up off the bottom of the pile for the Comets. Second down, Blue Jays.
Blue Jays keep pushing and pushing. Gaining even more yardage. What I heard from the players in the classrooms and in the hallways, they're pretty proud of their defense. Doesn't seem to be stacking up to what they've been saying tonight. Might be just an off game for them, though. Only time will tell.
False start, I would say, on the defensive end. False start against the Blue Jays, actually. That's going to back them up by 5 yards for the Blue Jays. And
playing a little game of cha-cha with the false starts here.
46-yard line. It assumes that there's another penalty flag on the field. False start.
False start on the Blue Jays again. 1, 2, 3, cha-cha-cha.
To another 5 yards, and ball's going to be on the 41-yard line. I mean, they can do this all day.
Yeah. Doing the old-fashioned tango down there on the football field. Back and forth, back and forth. Here we go.
And off play.
Pass
play.
He's wide out there.
Oh.
Pass is incomplete.
That would have been clutch if you would have had that. Like I said, Blue Jays had the buttery hands tonight.
That was a nice distraction by number 7, Tate Cal, waving his arms up. Completely threw off North Judson from making that catch. Seconds left to go. No Judson. Third down. About 19 yards to go. Comet, stop him. Number 77, Chris Smith.
Chris Smith with a stop for the Comets.
Fourth down
for the Blue Jays. Ball on the 41-yard line. 19 yards to go.
38-yard line, correction. And that's going to run out for the third quarter. Blue Jays 15, Comets 6. Thank you for tuning in to RTC TV. We'll get you back after the break.
My YouTube channel for gaming. Like, we live in close proximity. You want to co-commentate? Yeah. I didn't think you'd be against it. You can talk in my snowball. My snowball. I don't talk through the headset microphone anymore. I got a snowball microphone. It's pretty beast. We can backseat game and we can swap back and forth.
I think it's going to be fun going to away games.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to talk trash about the field.
But this is a terrible field.
I can backseat, like, you doing, like, a Call of Duty mod, by the way. Because you're definitely better at that than I am.
All right, and we're back. Whoa.
Wow, that was
nice.
Big for the Comets.
Nice. That's recovery there.
Let's see if we get, this is a good start for the fourth quarter. Let's see if they can get something going here.
Once again, before that play, welcome back to RTC TV. Wow, great start off right there. And the cheerleaders down there getting the crowd pumped for the fourth quarter, keeping everyone's spirits up as Comets are still down 6-15. Pass play by the Comets.
Oh,
incomplete.
A little overthrown. Hartman is.
Hartman overshot that a little bit.
That pass to Casey Oaks. Looks like Casey Oaks coming up a little shaken. Almost looked like
as if he maybe twisted his ankle.
That's not good.
And that is not good for the Comets. Casey, one of their top players. A lot of injuries for the Comets this game.
He's able to walk off the field, though.
Looks like Conrad's going to come in for him. And that brings up second down for the Comets. 10 yards to go. Ball on the 29-yard line. Handoff play to Blake Albright. Blake Albright is stopped immediately.
Oh, he's pushed back. He got nailed.
Stop made by 58, Gage Sin for the Blue Jays. Third down Comets.
Noah Judson defense just wreaking havoc on Caston's run plays tonight. Handoff plays, correction, my bad.
Oh, loses the ball. He's
Did they recover?
Down. That's going to bring up fourth down for the Comets. Ball on the 27-yard line. 8 yards to go.
Comets had a great start. They just can't keep it in the bag.
I mean, what are you looking for here, Dakota, on this situation?
Fourth down. I mean, 11 yards to go. They did get pushed back. I want to see a pass. I mean, it's rare for him to do it, but I want to see him go for a pass. I'm feeling lucky. I think they could do it. On the 30-yard line.
Here we go. See what the Comets can do here on fourth down. It's going to be, let's see if they can pull off one of these plays. Looks off, fake handoff. Brady Hartman going to the right. Oh, fumble. Comets recovered, but that's going to be turnover on down.
Either way.
Either way, Blue Jays going to have the ball. Sadly. Looking right above us, we have this big light pole, and there's a whole bunch of flies and just bugs all over the place.
Oh, yeah. It's wonderful.
Just wonderful for us, isn't it, Dakota?
Oh, yeah, definitely. It's starting to get annoying. I feel them crawling on my skin.
It looks like the Comets are looking. They're saying that they need a lineman and number 69.
69, that'd be Peyton Hendrick.
Comes in and fills in as a lineman.
Bit of a tank. It's going to flatten all of them. We got number 58 coming in, John Mitchell.
Be here second down for the Blue Jays. Ball on the 30-yard line. We got nine and a half minutes to go here in the fourth quarter. Blue Jays lead the game 15-6.
Comets need to pull off something big here. Here we go.
And off play, and he's fighting through, and he brings him down.
88, Tyler Blount on the carry. Alton Cowell had him in the racks. Third down for the Blue Jays.
Here we go.
Let's see what can happen here. We need some big stop for the Comets. This 8 yards to go. seems that they're having struggling getting guys out there on defense. I don't know if that's on the players' parts or on the coach's part, but...
53, Trenton Howard on that stop for the Comets.
Nice stop by Trenton Howard for the Comets. Seemed like the North Judd guy got whiplashed around in there.
Fourth down, Blue Jays.
Blue Jays will hit the fourth down. Still 8 yards to go.
Lewis to punt for the Blue Jays.
You don't have to give credit to Blue Jays or Judson's.
They are holding their ground.
I mean, they have some great kickers that punt the ball off, and they have some great punters on their team.
Oh, yeah. Give them credit where it's due.
And that's something that Caston honestly doesn't have. They don't. They don't have a kicker at all.
No. I mean, Roger Flint, he gets the job semi-done, but... he's not the best kicker that we can have. A little bit more improvement, though. I think he'll be good.
Yeah. Man, these bugs are just all over. Got one on your shoulder there.
Oh.
They're
sticking
just flying
to us.
All over the place. Gonna have to get some bug spray for the next game. If it's gonna continue to be like this.
Pass. Oh, almost intercepted. There wasn't anybody on our team near there, though.
Looks like Tate Cal and Conrad's coming back. They're coming out of the game. I don't know. They're just coming over to the side to talk to Coach Jones here.
Get an idea of what they're doing. There we go. Comets 10 yards to go on the 21st yard line.
Oh, fumble. Loss.
And the North Judd recovers.
And the Blue Jays recover the ball. And they'll be on the 21 yard line. Good, great position just to close out the game here.
This is not good for the Comets. Timeout was called. Thanks for tuning in to RTC TV. We'll be right back with you after the break.
Look how fast Alyssa's running.
No. No, I want you to go, Maddox. No, it's fine. No, Maddox, you can come. It's just, I'll be honest with you, it seemed kind of fun being just like the only guy in like a truckload of volleyball team. Like, seriously.
Oh, you travel with them?
Yeah, I travel with them. It's just fun, okay? But you can come, Max. I don't care. You do you. No.
Do they eat after the games?
After the games they usually eat, and during tournaments.
Like they eat somewhere?
No, not somewhere. They drink, though. They bring some pretty good food, though.
You eat their food, too?
Yeah, they feed me.
Oh, really?
Just like, oh, you're here. Here, have food. All right.
So you go tomorrow. What are you filming tomorrow?
The tourney that they got at Tri-County. So I got to do like 4 minutes.
Oh, wow. That's pretty good money, though.
Oh, yeah.
15. Did you get your paycheck today?
No, I did not. Like, we're
really?
Still figuring out how they're getting to us. Cause.
I got one today.
You got one today?
Yeah. $15 is just from the football game.
Maddox, you got paid today.
Yeah. Did you get paid today? Yeah, check came in came into the mail and I got it. $15.
Wait, through like the actual mail?
Yeah, like my mail at my house, like mailbox.
I'm checking the post office.
Yeah, mine came in.
Hot dog.
But yeah, because you did, how many games have you done? You done the last Friday, then you done, how many volleyball games?
That was two that week, and then there was Saturday stuff.
Should have at least $45 or something.
I think my estimated was 60.
60?
Yeah,
that's good. Yo, I hate these type of bugs, too.
Oh, yeah. It's getting terrible. hopefully next time we'll be able to set up in the press box.
Actually, we'll be away next time. What am I talking about?
Yeah, so we got... I wonder if we can get into their press box or not. They'll let us...
I don't know. I was told to talk to our athletic director about that. I might speak to Molenkoff later. And we're back. Thanks again for tuning in to RTC TV. Comets down 6-15. They have the ball. We're looking to see a really big move here.
Hand off to number 88, Blue Jays running back. He's brought down out of bounds.
Second down for the Blue Jays.
It's on the 23rd yard line, 9 yards to go, second down.
Here we go, as the Blue Jays set up here on the offensive end. Handoff play to number 7 in the running back, fullback actually.
I'd like to correct my mistake earlier. I said the Comets had the ball. My bad, it's North Judd. They have
Dakota,
the ball.
What are you thinking?
I don't know, okay?
You got the best view of the game, and here you are thinking that. Comets have ball when actually the Blue Jays have ball.
Well, you know what? I'm not
actually,
very observant.
Actually, Dakota, I'm going to have to take you to the eye doctor after this game. Have your eyes get checked.
Probably that time of the year again. Yeesh.
I like it.
They'll bring up third down with 7 yards to go. Ball on the 21-yard line for the Blue Jays.
Comets got to keep them back. Oh. The North Judd kids got just knocked down from the back. Couldn't tell if that was one of ours that did that or maybe he tripped. I don't know.
That'll bring up fourth down with 1 yard to go.
We're over 6 minutes to go. North Judd, fourth down. Don't have too far to go, but the Comets need to keep them back.
And there's that quarterback sneak by the Blue Jays, and he's pushing right through, and he picks up the first down for the Blue Jays. Ball will be on the 14-yard line.
Blue Jays on the quarterback keeper up the middle. Enough for the first down. The ball to 13-yard line.
She's not looking good. Crowd's calling for defense here for the Comets, but so far they haven't been able to hold up.
Looks like a flag is called.
Penalty flag on the field.
Looks to be a false start. North Judd. That'll help. How much, we'll figure out.
First down for the Blue Jays. We got 15 yards, ball on the 18-yard line.
I'd have to say, spirits looking pretty low here in the stands.
Brady Hartman on the sideline looks like he's stretching out his hamstrings.
Marcos on the carry. Stop made by 52 Phoenix Singleton for the Comets. Second down, Blue Jays.
Second down for the Blue Jays, 13 to go.
Man, these bugs are just eating me alive.
Yeah.
But we're staying strong. We're going to bring you this great commentary.
Yeah.
These bugs ain't going to stop us.
No way, man.
But here, second down for the Blue Jays, 13 yards to go. Ball on the 16-yard lines. Comets, I think they're looking a little tired out there as getting it to the end of the game here.
It's been a very taxing game.
Pick up
for
their
the
endurance
Comets,
here and finish out.
It's been very taxing on them.
Career on the carry. Take Powell in there on the stop. Third down for the Blue Jays. Football's at the 15-yard line.
Thirteen yards to go for Blue Jays to the 15-yard line. Third down for them. Little over 3.5 minutes left. We'll see what the Comets can pull out of their sleeve here as we get to the end of the fourth quarter.
Team Boyd on the carry.
Be here. Three minutes to go here in the fourth quarter. Blue Jays lead 15-6.
Fourth down for the Blue Jays.
Just under 3 minutes left to go. Fourth down for the Blue Jays. 8 yards to go. Ball's on the 11th yard line. Comets need to do something here. Like, seriously. We're getting down to the nitty gritty here.
There'll be a timeout.
Timeout by Blue Jays. We'll be right back with you after the break.
Before you close out like officially, then I'll like be sure to check us out on Facebook and
so you'll
share.
You'll do that, then I'll close out.
You close out, and then I'll say that.
Okay.
But we'll see you next time. We'll see you next Friday. I don't know where the game is now.
I don't know. We'll just see you next Friday.
Yeah.
We'll see you next time.
Yeah. Just say that.
And we're back after the break. Thanks again for tuning in to RTC TV.
2.5 minutes to go here in the fourth quarter. Comets trail 6-15. Looks to be a hole.
Left end, there's a penalty flag thrown out there about the 13-yard line.
With calling penalty.
Penalty holding against the Blue Jays.
On the Blue Jays. And I'd like to point something out real quick. It's a known fact that most schools tend to not really make fun, but point out that Caston has a lot of cheerleaders. But I'm looking over there and I counted about, there's quite a few cheerleaders over there for North Judson supporting their team as well. And there's just about as many. I don't understand what all the complaining's about. But to be honest with you, I'm not complaining a bit. I mean, cheerleaders are cheerleaders. The more, the better. But in my honest opinion, they bring great morale to the crowd and keep us all in high spirits, even if we are trailing by 9 points.
Fourth down for the Blue Jays.
Looks like they're trying to figure out. Set the ball up in place. Here goes the Blue Jays. We got fourth down. 20 yards to go for the Blue Jays, and ball is on the 23-yard line. Comets need a big stop.
flag out by the ref.
Penalty flag on the field.
Penalty flag is thrown out onto the field. That's going to be fourth down and 25 yards to go.
The Blue Jays just don't like being close to their end zone, man. They keep backing up. Either that, or they're going to try and be humiliating and make a really big play here. But I don't hope for that. Making a pass by the Blue Jays.
Looks like
that's... Oh! Ooh, almost an interception by number 35, Colton Wilkins.
You would think that the next comments football practice would just pretty much be on catching the football on the defense end.
I'd say for both teams, they've all got sticky fingers tonight.
They just got the butter hands tonight.
Butter hands, that's
butter,
what I
butter.
Butter. Great on bread, not for playing football. Here we go, Comet's got the ball. 28-yard line.
Pass play here by Brady Hart. Settling back, and he's getting brought down. Looks like he hesitated too much right there. You just need to...
I think they're getting tired.
Run up the middle, or... Just hesitated, and...
He didn't have too
many
open spots.
Can't do that long with the Comet's linemen. I mean, they're going to come right through them.
Yeah.
State Cows coming in. Conrad coming back into the game. We got 1 minute and 55 seconds to go here in the fourth quarter. Hartman looking for the pass. He's going to get... That's going to be incomplete. He is down. Looks like
where
the
was
penalty flag
that?
Is thrown again out onto the field.
There was nobody there. Official calling a timeout. We'll be back with you real quick.
Retribution tonight. Come on. I made up for it.
Yeah. Penalty was intentional grounding against the Comets. Loss of down on the play. Makes it third down.
And we're back after that short break. Called a penalty against the Comets. Pushed him back a little bit. I think.
Yeah, that's going to push him back to the 7-yard line. So it looks like Tate Cow. I'm not sure who number 44 is. Do you know who number 4 is, Dakota?
44?
Yeah.
That'd be Zach Slocum.
Zach Slocum. That is right. And then we got Conrad back into the game.
Here we go with Comets getting ready for the next play here. They got a lot of ground to cover.
1 minute and 35 seconds to go here in the fourth quarter.
It does not look
like,
bright.
Hey, looks like Conrad, as you can see. Looks like he took Hartman's spot in the quarterback position. I mean, kind of an interesting move there. We've never seen Conrad there. This is his first year playing. And just takes him back to safety. I don't think that was a very smart move by the Comets at all.
No.
I mean.
Zach Conrad being new to the quarterback position, definitely.
I could see, you know, you're down and there's only a minute left and try some new players. But, I mean, this is high school football. You know, I don't know why you would want to put someone in there that's never had experience yet. I think if you want to do that, you're going to have to do that with the scrimmage game and test new people out. See how they do. But like I said, I mean, it's his first time, so, I mean, it's fine. But I think in this situation, I mean, you're down. You need to try to get as much yards as you can.
Regardless, Conrad's going to get a lot of heat in the locker room for that one.
Especially when you're down. I mean...
Lining up for a kickoff again.
Phoenix Singleton to kick off for the Comets.
Ooh, and we got Phoenix up there, number 52, to kick it off for the Comets. Minute 30 Cubs. Left to go.
Cubs getting right here, kick the ball off. I think they're going to go for that squid kick, honestly. It looks like, you know, Blue Jays are set up as if all the guys are over to the left side. Yeah, it looks like
straight
he does.
Down.
Lewis on the reception. Takes a knee down to the football.
They planted the ball down right there on the 40-yard line. 43. That's close.
Once again, it looks like Comets are yelling instantly that they need an in.
Trying to scramble up enough players to get in a play here.
They're just running short on players here.
Well, everyone's getting hurt. Handoff by North Judd.
Up to the 50, and he is down right at the 51-yard line.
Solid yard game by North Judd.
That's going to bring up second down with 5 yards to go.
Second down for the Blue Jays. Ball resting at the 50-yard line.
One minute left to go on the clock for fourth quarter.
And you can find all these games on our website at www.rtctv4.com. Be sure to check out our Facebook page also and our YouTube channel too. You'll also find a whole bunch of other videos that we video. Share the videos. Be sure to share them. Check them out. Share them with your friends. Watch them with family. And... we are happy to do this and cover all the sports here at Caston.
Yep, we cover everything from football to volleyball to soccer. Do some highlights from other sports. And it looks like that's going to be the game. They're running out the clock as we speak right now. Well, that's going to do it for tonight's game as the fourth quarter ends. North Judd wins 17, Comets 6. We thank you all for tuning in to RTC TV. My name's Dakota Hayden, and with my commentating buddy Galen Rensler.
We will see you next Friday, and be sure to tune in to our Facebook page and be alive. Like our page and be alert on all the updates, and we'll catch you next Friday on RTC TV 4. Once again, thank you for tuning in.